Day two here at the BioInvestor Forum in San Francisco. Joining me right now is Bryan Oronsky and James Brown, both from EpicentRx. Good to have you both.
Thank you, Christine.
So Bryan, I'll start with you. Just give us an overview of the company.
Right. So EpicentRx is a biotech company with really focus on anti-cancer agents.
Okay.
We have two platforms. The first platform is a small molecule platform, and the second platform are oncolytic viruses. Both of these target tumors in a very non-toxic way. So the advantage of these agents that we're using to attack cancer is that we hope that they, number one, improve quantity of life, but also quality of life. That's very important. Patients, you know, who have cancer, who are, you know, live longer time, but are on the couch the whole time because they feel terrible, that doesn't seem like a victory.
And how does the technology work, and how is it different than anything else out there right now?
Right. Well, the small molecules are interesting because the small molecules are derived from high energetic compounds. So they're basically their closest relatives are rocket propellant and explosives. So
Okay.
when we say this is literally rocket science, we mean it. The small molecule, our lead small molecule, is called RRX001.
Okay.
And it's about to enter phase three for small cell lung cancer, which is one of the deadliest cancers. It divides really more rapidly than any other cancer type, short of Burkitt's lymphoma. Patients, you know, live on average less than 6 months, especially after they receive first-line chemotherapy treatment. So the advantage of RRX001 is really threefold. One is, by itself, it's very minimally toxic. In fact, really the one and arguably only toxic side effect of the drug is that when we infuse it, when we deliver it intravenously, it causes a little bit of mild tingling and itching.
Okay.
Which is actually a favorable side effect because it makes it very difficult to blind clinical trials. So in our phase three, we will be operating this open label, which means both the patient and the physician and the sponsor, which is EpicentRx, will know how the patients are doing in real time. So that's a good thing. I think the second thing that's interesting about the drug, and I think very beneficial, is that it not only improves the efficacy of chemotherapy, which it does, and that's very nice, a single agent activity, but it improves the efficacy of chemotherapy in a way that enables you to use chemotherapy again when it no longer was working. So you take a patient, they may have previously received the chemotherapy, it may have worked or not worked, but now in a later line, you can give the chemotherapy again. And I think the third advantage, which ties into all of this, is that one of the, I would say, off-target effects of the drug is that it seems to reduce the toxicity of chemotherapy and radiation. And in fact, one of the Armed Forces Radiobiologic Institute in Bethesda, Maryland, is looking at RRX001, is evaluating it as a radio protector in case of a dirty bomb or a nuclear bomb or a nuclear meltdown. So it has these properties whereby you give the chemotherapy or you give radiation, and the toxicity to the normal tissues is less. And that enables you to give more of the chemotherapy. And really, I would say, if, you know, if RRX001 is doing its job properly, patient lives longer and feels better while he's alive or she's alive.
And that actually leads to what I think is one of the most interesting things about the drug, which is effectively we're looking to turn cancer into a chronic disease as opposed to a deadly disease.
Right.
So that it can be managed over the course of time. Chemotherapy in connection with our drug could be given repeatedly, we've seen good results from that so far. You know, so that it's not a death sentence, it's a chronic disease, much like HIV.
Right, and that's an important point, right? Because, you know, normally the way cancer is standardly treated is you receive lines of therapy. So it's a linear process. You get one therapy, and then when the cancer progresses or gets worse, in this case, progression is not a good thing, it's a worse thing. The cancer gets worse, and then that triggers a switch to another therapeutic agent, right? Chemotherapy, targeted agent, or immunotherapy. But eventually, after time, most patients become resistant. And when they become resistant not just to the drug that they were being treated with, but also to other agents, right? It's called multi-drug resistance. And so If you can now reverse multi-drug resistance, which is in effect what we're claiming RX-001 may be able to do, pending, you know, the outcome of our phase 3 trial, then you'll be able to resensitize patients to therapies, chemotherapy, targeted agents, potentially immunotherapy as well, and you reset, you know, the whole paradigm here, because instead of a linear march towards hospice or death, you're now restarting them from first line or second line, and potentially you can continually do this kind of in a loop. So you change something that's linear, progressing in one direction, into more of a loop.
So when would you expect top line data from phase 3?
We think by 2020 we'll have a readout. And as I said, you know, since the trial should be open label, we'll have a readout really in real time as we go.
Okay.
So that's very exciting.
And the company is private. What's the timeline to take the company public?
Company's private right now. We're evaluating taking it public in the next few months. Not sure exactly what the timeline will be, but I would guess that sometime middle of next year we probably will be very serious about doing that.
Very exciting to hear.
Thank you
both for joining me today.
Thank you.
Thank you.